This tutorial shows how to design a non-anchored sheet pile wall using the Sheeting Design program. First of all, we have to choose which methodology we will use in analyzing the structure. In our example, we will choose Eurocode Design Approach 3, which reduces soil parameters. Then we will input the geological profile. We will assume a homogeneous soil, which means that we can move straight to inputting the soil parameters. We will input the name of the soil, the unit weight, the angle of internal friction, the cohesion, and the angle of friction between the structure and the soil, and add the soil into the profile. The excavation depth will be 3.5 meters. We assume that it will be formed by a sheet pile wall of type 1AN. The material will be FE360. Anchors, props, and supports can be skipped, as this will be a non-anchored wall. We will move straight to determining the pressure. No limits of deformation of the structure were set, so we can consider the pressure acting on the structure as the active pressure. We will set a minimal dimensioning pressure as 20% of the geostatic stress. All the other buttons in this frame are used for redistribution of earth pressures when analyzing anchored and strutted walls. Next, we will input the shape of the terrain, which will be in a 1:5 slope. Next, we input the water. Water is present both in front of the structure and behind it. However, it cannot flow under the structure. Behind the structure, it is leveled with the terrain, and in front of the structure, it is 2 meters below the top of the wall. Surcharge and other forces will not be considered. Earthquake will also not be defined. The design situation will be set as permanent. Now we will move to the frame analysis. The program calculated the necessary depth of the structure as 5.12 meters. Detailed results can be displayed by pressing the button in detail. When we move to the frame dimensioning, we can see that for the maximum moment, our wall is not satisfactory. We must therefore go back to the frame geometry, where we change the size of the sheet pile wall from 1AN to 2N. When we now switch to dimensioning, we can see that the sheet pile wall is satisfactory. The final step is the analysis of the global stability of the structure. The program informs us that the necessary depth of the structure is 5.12 meters. We must therefore input a higher value, for example 5.5 meters, and run slope stability, where we check the global stability of the structure. The program will automatically find the worst slip surface. We can see that the results are satisfactory. The design of a non-anchored sheet pile wall is now complete. More information can be found in other video tutorials, online help, engineering manuals, and verification manuals. Should you have any questions, please contact our support team.